Hi guys, welcome to Pilates Booty. Ready to work that booty. We'll start with a little warm up. We'll work all the muscles in the glute area and then we will cool it down and stretch it out so you leave feeling good. All right? Start with a little prince. We'll start seated, okay? So either your legs are straight out, or you could take a simple seated position, whatever works for you and your body. Wherever you are, you're gonna sit up nice and tall. Rest the hands on the legs, either face down for grounding or up for energy. You can place your thumb and forefeet together. It feels good, it's a soothing movement. You're gonna close your eyes. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Gently exhale through the mouth. And again, inhale through the nose, nice deep breath. And exhale, circle your head all the way around. And reverse the direction of your circle. And head back to the center. Open those eyes, roll those shoulders to the back. Honey, I said, float, red carpet. And lift your arms up. Take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, open the arms, drop your left hand down, stretch that right arm over the head. Lift and twist. Right hand behind you, left hand on the knee. You want to try to twist that torso, wake up that spine, get those organs squeezed and ready to work. And release, left arm out, inhale. Stretch. I started to worry. Lift and twist, left hand behind you, right hand on the knee. And release. And then let's straighten our legs out in front of us. Lift your arms up, take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, forward fold. So round your spine, completely relax your spine. Drop your head and just hold your stretch. Wake up your spine, wake up your legs. Even here, scoop that belly button back. Always work your core. Try to make it like, so you don't have to think about it. You know what I mean? Make it a habit. Look up and flex if you can. Grab your toes if not, reach for your shins. When you grab your toes, if you can, I'm also stretching my calves and it's a lovely thing. Round and point, belly button in. And roll it up. All right, we're gonna start on our back. Soften your knees. Take it all the way down. All right, hands down by your side. So we'll graduate into more advanced movements. I'll always give you options, all right? So if one option doesn't work for you, use another, and rest is always an option too. Remember your body, your choice. Arms down by your side. You're gonna start with some bridges. So line your feet up with your knees and your hips. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, tilt your hips, and then peel off of the mat. We're just going for a diagonal line from the knees, the hips, to the shoulders. And then peel it back down. Belly button in, one vertebrae at a time. The last thing down is my hips. Inhale, tilt, exhale. Peel off of the mat, squeeze. Good, take it down, one vertebrae at a time. Two more, just like that. Inhale, exhale, tilt, peel off your mat. Squeeze those glutes. Take it down, one vertebrae at a time. We're gonna do that one more time, then we're gonna add a little something, something. Tilt those hips, peel off your mat. Hold it there. Now we're gonna do small pulses with our legs. Pulse, pulse, inward, pulse, pulse. Pulse, pulse, one more set. Good, hold it here. If you can or if you'd like, right leg up. We're gonna do small circles. Four, three, two, one. Reverse, four, three, two. Now you're gonna lower your booty and then lift. Lower, lift. If you can, really think of keeping your knee lined up with your hip, trying not to let that knee wing out to the side. Woo-hoo! Two more. Last time, hold it up. Leg lowers. Lift, lower. Lift, lower. Lift, lower. Lift, four more. Three. Two. You've got an ass I never seen. Come on, what a perfect song. All right, let's point that left leg up. Try to hit those leg circles. Four, three, two, one. Reverse. Lower your boots and lift. Low. Lift, lower, lift, lower, lift. Four more. Two more. Pull the last one. Woohoo! Lower the leg. Lift. You got to slow it down. One more. Take that foot back down if you can. Keep those hips lifted. And again, pulse those legs. Pulse, 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 pulse again. Pull. Gently lower. Woo-wee. Stretch it out. Pull the knees into the chest. The closer you can get the knees to the chest, the more I'm stretching out the booty and my lower back. Okay, we're going to take it onto our sides. We give that part of our bottom a rest. And let's work the side booty. So we'll start laying on our left side. If you have a mat, you're going to take your bottom to the back of your mat and your legs to the front. If you're on the floor and you don't have a mat, then just make sure your body is angled. You can be propped up like this if you'd like. You can take it here. If your neck gets sore, you can lay here. So anything you want to do with that upper body, all right? I'm going to start here. Sometimes I'm taking it down through my neck. Take your right hand, just place it on the mat in front of you. And then make sure you're not leaning back on your hips or too far forward. Stack those hips straight up. Keep your joints lined up. Lift your top leg slightly. Flex your foot and toss. Four, three, two, point, eight, three, two. Small circles. When you circle, it also forces you to engage your core if you can't feel that. Reverse your circle. So you're going to do a big circle. Big giant circle. From here, try to rotate in that hip joint to the back and then back to neutral. Forward, ceiling, rotate back and down. So we're really trying to loosen that hip joint as well. Lift, rotate back and down. One more this direction. Forward, lift. You really have to squeeze your core as well. That's why I love Pilates. Core activation. Reverse. Lift. Forward. Down. Back. Lift. Forward. Down. Two more. Last time. So you're going to take it to neutral. We're going to do a batma or a kick. We call it lift. Lift, lift, lift. Four more. Three, two, one. Now I'm going to take that leg forward. Flex the foot. Point, reach it to the back. Squeeze your bottom. Flex the foot forward. Point, squeeze your glutes. Flex forward. Point back. Flex forward. Point back. Every time that leg goes forward, put your belly button in. Activate that core. Flex forward. Point back. Two more. Flex forward. Point back. Flex forward. One more time. Point back. You're going to bicycle. Be passé. Develop. Point back. Bend. Flex. Unfold. Point. Reach it back. Passé. Develop. Point and reach. Pase. Develope. Reach. Reverse. You take it. Flex forward. Point. Develop to the back. Flex straight leg forward. Bend. Take it to the back. Flex. Bend. Reach. One more. Bend. Reach. Good. Take it back to neutral. Flex your foot. You're going to point it down. Up. Down. Up. Down. Up. Down. This one's a good one. Four. And with a bang. Three. Two. Holy moly. One. Two. I don't know about you, but that one got me. You need to punch it out. It really works. Relax that muscle we just tensed up. All right, let's press it up. If you need to, stretch out that hip. There's nothing worse than overuse, ladies. Overuse is real, especially when you get older like me. Woo! If you can, you cross the leg over the foot and reach for your feet. Again, you can reach for your shin. Oh, that's a good stretch. Stretching also helps to alleviate soreness from our workouts, and it helps us sleep better and feel better throughout the day. So always stretch out after your workouts. Always, always, always. Stretch every day. Every day. I'm preaching over here. All right. Honestly, though, it eliminates pain. So let's see the other side and put some pain in the butte. Either you sit to the back edge of your mat, or you just scoot your butt back and get an angle with that body. So remember, you can lay your head, you can prop it up, you can even come up here if you'd like, whatever is comfortable for you. I like to take it down. Remember to stack your hips, one on top of the other. Left hand in front of you, flex your feet, lift your top leg. There we go, and lift, 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 lift. Let's point that foot around, say circle. It's too late. And reverse. You're like, don't quit your day job, Tanya. Big circle. You take it forward, nice and controlled. Lift. Rotate in that hip socket to the back. And back to the start. Forward. Lift up. Rotate in that hip socket. And back to neutral. Two more. Pull that belly button in every time that leg goes forward. Take that leg back and down. This is great for range of motion in your hips. Hip loosener, hip strengthener. Reverse, take your leg to the back. Squeeze your glutes. Lift your leg up. Take it forward, squeeze your abs. Take it down. To the back, squeeze your glutes. Lift. Forward. Down, head is feeling heavy. I'm gonna lay down. Lift. Forward. One more time. Four more. Three. Two. One. Good. You're going to keep that leg forward and flex. Point, reach your back, squeeze your glutes. Flex forward. Point, reach your back. Flex forward. Point, reach your back. Flex forward. Point, reach your back. Four more. And point back. Flex forward. Squeeze your tummy. Point back. Squeeze your glutes. Two more. Forward. Back. Forward. Here we go. Into our bicycle. You're going to bend or passe. Left front fold. Point and reach to the back. Passe. Develope. Point and reach it back. And passe. Develope. Point and reach it back. Keeping a little French ballet. Reverse. Flex forward. Straight leg. Bend. Develope to the back. Flex forward. Passe. Develope. Two more. Flex forward. Passe. Develope. Last time. Flex forward. Passe. Develope. Good. Take it back to the center. Here we go. Finishing with our clenches. Flex down. Turn it up. Down. Up. Try to rotate the whole leg. The whole hip. Four. Three. Two. One. And take sink it down. Good. Can you do punch it out? Let's press it up. Let's stretch that hip. And then we're going to take it back to the back side of the glute. We're going to lay on our belly. So right now, crush your foot over. If you can't crush your foot over, just lay it beside you. This one I still get it stressed, but this one's deeper. So whatever works for you. Can only make me stronger. Because I can't get much stronger. Actually, we're not wrong or right. We're working out. Getting stronger. Okay. Let's actually take it down to the elbows first, and then we'll lay on our boudet. Yep. All right, so this one I love. I do the same series, but I do it up on a tabletop, and it's super duper effective. However, this one just changes it up a little bit. Number one, it takes the wrist joint out of it. Number two, it puts a little more challenge into your core, and being at the angle, it's gonna put a little more challenge on your bottom as well, okay? So on the elbows, we're gonna keep our belly button pulled up the whole time, all right? Always be aware of your core. Core is one of the most important things on our body, okay? If we have a weak core, everything else kind of falls off the wayside. So pulling the belly button up at the end, not only am I telling my body to engage my core and I'm working gently, but I'm protecting my spine. I'm less likely to hurt my back if I'm using my core. Okay, just a mental note for all of your exercises, all right? Whenever you work out, pull that belly button up. Okay, so don't arch, don't round, find a nice diagonal line. If you're looking in your camera, if you have a mirror, check here, you can check. And relax your head. When I lift my chin up, I put tension in my neck muscles, and y'all, we have normal daily tension in our neck, so we don't wanna add more, all right? So put the tension in your belly. You're gonna take your right leg up, and you're gonna not just keep it at this angle. Since we're on our elbows, you're gonna lift it higher. Let's just put your pointed downward and pulse, 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 pulse. Point that foot for 8, 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, small circles. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1, and reverse. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. You're gonna lower your toe and lift back up. Lower, lift, lower, lift. Lower, lift. The straighter you can keep that knee, the more I'm working that hamstring along with that glute. Two more. Good, you're gonna bend, extend, bend, extend, bend, extend, bend, extend, bend, extend, bend, extend, bend, extend. Two more. We're gonna double up that kick. Pulse. Pulse, extend. Pulse, pulse, extend. Pulse, pulse, extend. Pulse, pulse, extend. 4, 3, 2, 1. Then you're gonna pull it in. Lift it up. You can keep that knee bent. Lift. Pull. And lift. 4 more. Knee in. Lift. 3, 2. You're gonna hold the last one up. Lift that. 5. Good, now we're gonna bring it down and out to the side like a fire hydrant, and then lift back up. Down, fire hydrant. Down, lift. Down, fire hydrant. Down, lift. Down, fire hydrant. Down, lift. 4 more. 3, 2, 1, you're gonna hold the last one to the side. Yes, and pulse it up. 7, 6, 5, 4, 3, 2, 1. Take it down. Woo, woo, woo. Stretch it back. Give your little shoulders a break. Pardon me. You can lean it side to side. And then let's take it down to the other side. Okay? So again, back down, on those elbows. When we're on the elbows, try not to sink. If you can see that, don't sink. I'm gonna pull up and I'm lining my spine up and my head up, and then my belly button is pulled up. I'm gonna take my left leg back higher than my center line. Flex the foot and pulse it up. Three, two, keep pulling that belly button in. Point your foot. Three, two, small circles. Eight, seven, six, five, four, three, two, one, and reverse. You're gonna lower yourself and lift, lower, lift, lower, lift, lower, lift. Four more. Three, two, one. Hold it here. You're gonna bend and extend. Bend, extend. If you can, lift that thigh past the center line. Four more. Three, two. Here we go for a double pulse. And pulse, pulse, extend. Pulse, pulse, extend. Pulse, pulse, extend. Pulse, pulse, extend. Four, three, two, one. And knee pull, in, lift, in, lift, in, lift, in, lift. Four more. Three, two, one. Hold it there. And lift, 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 lift. Going into the last series. We go in, fire hydrant. Down, lift. Down, fire hydrant. Down, lift. Lower, fire hydrant. Lower, lift. Lower, fire hydrant. Good. Four. My supporting leg that's killing me. Two more. Ah, I might die. One, getting a cramp, and lower. I don't know why getting a cramp makes me laugh. It's a hurt laugh. Oh my goodness. Woo. All right, let's roll it up. And again, let's do a little stretch for that booty. You can take your soles of your feet together this time. And then grab onto the ankles, not the toes. I'd rather you not tweak out your joints. Keep your joints lined up. And you're just going to press those knees open. If you want, you can take your right elbow on your right knee and then gently press that left knee open. Great hip opener. I don't know about you all, but I get tighter in my hips as they get older. Change. Left elbow. Press that right knee away. Right? What doesn't kill you makes you stronger. Woo! Okay, now we're going to finish, or we're going to actually just take it up to the standing position. That might, may or may not be our last one. But this one's a great standing Pilates exercise. So just take it into a child's pose. You're going to tuck your toes under, and let's just take it up into a downward dog to start. And then just walk your feet towards your hands. Soften your knees. Belly button is pulled in. Roll it up one vertebrae at a time. Okay, this one is a single knee pull in a lunge position. Love it. It's great for the thigh. Great for the glute, the leg. It's also a nice little cardio boost, all right? You don't have to jump and bounce around and kill yourself to get good cardio, all right? If you just engage your thigh muscles, that's all you need to do. Get those thigh muscles working and your heart rate goes up, all right? So let's start with our right knee forward, left toe back. So your lunge doesn't have to be this deep. It can be here, or it can go deeper, all right? Again, your body, your choice. You don't want to let your knee pass your foot, so make sure your joints are lined up. Sorry about that. All right, reach your arms forward, belly button in. So again, I'm lining all my joints up. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, pull your left knee in. Stretch it back. Pull it in. Stretch it back. Pull it in. Stretch it back. Pull it in. Stretch it back. Four more. Back. Three. Woo! Take it back. Two. Last one. And back. Hip step it together. Oh my goodness. Take it back with your right leg. Again, a small one or a deep one. Belly button in. Angle your body. Inhale. Exhale. Pull your right knee in. Take it back. Woo! Pull it in. Ah! Take it back. Pull it in. Sorry, this is my boot leg. If you don't know what that means, I had Achilles tendonitis and I had a boot on. And it's only been out for a week. So this is hard. Four. Yeah. Three. Two more. Last time. Good. Step it together. Open those arms. Let's take a nice deep breath in. Exhale, open. Woo! And let's do the chin to chest. Forward fold, pull your belly button up. Good. Make sure your feet are under your hips. Belly button again, still pulled up. Let's fold our hands. Elbow and what do you call it? Hand and elbow. And let's hang in traction, all right? Belly button up, drop your head. Soften your knees. Keep your belly button pulled up. If you'd like, you can sway side to side. It's lovely traction on the whole upper body, the spine, the neck. You can shake your head no or nod yes. Loosen up that neck. And let's walk it back out. Let's stay to the plank position. And then lower down your mat ever so gently if you can. You can also take your knees down first if you'd like. And point those feet. Rest it up. And pull it back. Stretch out that back. We're going to do one more. All right, so this one is a double leg kick, okay? So we're gonna take it all the way on the belly. Lay your upper body also on the belly. And then if you can, you're gonna clasp your hands behind you and your elbows are soft. If this is not a comfortable position, you can just lay your arms by your side. It's totally okay, all right? Otherwise, the clasping gives you a benefit of a good, really deep chest opener as well. All right. You're going to take both feet back to your bottom, flex and point. Lower, take a breath in. Exhale, everything that's up, straighten your arms, and then lower. Kick, one, two, lower, inhale. Exhale, lift, squeeze, lower. Kick, flex, point, lower, inhale. Exhale, lift, lower, flex, point, lower, lift, lower. Let's pick up the pace, flex, point, lower. Lift, lower, flex, point, lower, lift, lower, flex, point, lower, lift, flex, point, lift. Two more. Lift, flex, point, lift. And hands by the chest. Rest it up. Woo. Stretch it back. Again, belly button in. Take it back. Forehead on the mat. And let's roll it up. And let's sit on our bottoms. And let's end with a little boute stretch. All right, take it down. Okay. Take your right foot, cross it over your left. You could stay there and press that right knee open. Or you could pick the foot up, grab behind your thigh. If you need a deeper stretch, if that's fine for you, stay there. If you need deeper, you cross all the way over. If you can, you wrap. Oh no, never mind, you don't wrap. You cross over, and then I have to lift my head and I grab either my shins or my feet. And then I pull my legs in ever so awkwardly, but it feels so wonderful. hips and same side. So then you can go to that four. You can also pick your leg up, or deeper, you can cross it over and pick up. You either grab your shins or your feet. Pull it in, stretch those hips. Lovely. Unfold wherever you are. Pull the knees into the chest. You could stay there or you could take a happy baby. If you're not very flexible, grab around your shin and let the knees hang open. Otherwise, under those feet. It's lovely for the hips. It's lovely for the hamstring. It's lovely for the lower back. Rocking is a massage also in the lower back. It's also soothing for our little head. Knees in. Roll it up. Stretch your legs out in front of you. Lift up. Take a deep breath in. Exhale, forward fold. Belly button in. Stretch it over. I'm going to go a little farther now than I did when I first started. Because I'm nice and warm. Look. Again, if you can't reach your toes, go for your shins. Otherwise, stretch those calves. Very important. Stretching the calves. We don't. And we get plantar fasciitis, and we get Achilles tendonitis, and guess what? No fun. So stretch your back. Can't promote stretching enough. Stretch. Round and point. I'm a big promoter of stretching. All right, let's finish. Again, you can keep your legs straight out if you're not comfortable in your seated position. Otherwise, take your simple seated position. Sit up nice and tall. I like to finish with breath. All of my classes, I like to cool down so you leave feeling good and not all exhausted. Oxygen is healing, all right? So let's heal our bodies. Either hands face down for grounding or up for energy, your choice. Close your eyes. Take a deep breath in through the nose. Hold in. And exhale through the mouth. Inhale through the nose. Deep breath. Fill your lungs with air. Hold it in. Exhale through the mouth, closing the rib cage. One last breath. Inhale. Hold it in. Exhale, let's circle our head all the way around. Getting rid of any tension that may remain in the body. And reverse your circle. And head back to the center. You can keep your eyes open now. Lift your arms up. Take a deep breath in. Good. Exhale, open left hand behind you. Right hand in the navel. Switch that torso. And let's switch. Last breath in. Oxygen. Inhale. Exhale. In. Yay! Moves like jabbers. Does he do this? I don't think so. Thanks for coming, you guys. Hopefully you got a lovely workout. See you next time.